And welcome to another tutorial episode on how to create a cinematic title trailer in Filmora 12. First, import your media files to be used in this project. Drag the audio file to the timeline. Then adjust and analyze the audio bit. At 16 seconds and 6 frames, delete the rest of the audio. Let's fade out the audio at 1 second. Once done, let's go to the titles option. Select and drag the default title to the timeline. Select the title and then type any text of your choice. Let's type simple and easy. Go to font and choose the Montserrat Extra Bold Italic. Select 70% as your font size. Then go to the line spacing, set the line spacing at 7, scroll down, click on advanced, go to the animation tab and click no animation. Now let's go back to the customize tab, turn on the fill option, under the fill option select the image fill, click on the image fill to add any image of your choice. Once done, let's also change the text effect, select any text effect desired. Scroll down to the shadow option, change the color of the shadow effect to white. Also set the bra at 1 and the distance at 1. Now let's copy and paste the text on the first track. On the second track, hide the text. Type the text desired. Once done, change the font to Montserrat Extra Light and the font size to 32. Then click on Italic and change the line spacing to 7. Now let's unhide the text on the second track. Let's select all text and split them based on the audio bit. Between the audio bit, let's delete the text. Please remember to follow the steps and repeat the same procedure. You can also change the text depending on your choice. However, changes were also made on the last text. To do that, go to Advanced and add another quick text. Type letter C and change its font size to 150. or send a text to C Network. Once done with the text, hide all text on the first track. Take screenshots of all text on the second track. Then let's add keyframes on the text on the second track. To do that, skip 3 frames and add a keyframe basing on the scale on the text. Let's say if the scale is at 74.6, add a keyframe. Then add another keyframe at the start of the text at 400. Once done, adjust the length of the text on the second keyframe. Then drag the screenshot to the timeline. Again, we are going to repeat the same procedure for the rest of the text. Aggressive and a powerful text, there's no need to take a screenshot. So on the last text, we are dealing with 2 texts, that is the C text and the network text. Therefore, we'll be adding keyframes on each of the text. Once done, render the project. Now let's go on the third track. We are going to add the pan and zoom effect on the screenshot. So on the first screenshot, select the screenshot, go to pan and zoom option, and choose the zoom in option. Adjust the range. We'll do this for the rest of the text except the present text. For the present text, set the rate at 1750 and 984. For the rest of the text, the rate remains the same. Now let's dot the reflection file on the timeline, adjust the reflection video, under the blend mode, set the reflection file at overlay. Now for each text, let's add a reflection video. Also, once done, let's add the background video on the timeline. Remember, the video is on screen under the blend mode. Select the background video, go to colors, change the tint to 76%. Also, again, let's add and adjust the video background on each of the text. Once done, at the end of the video on the last text, let's reduce the opacity. Go at the end of the text, skip one frame, and reduce the opacity at zero. We are going to do this for all the text on the first track, second track, third track, two on the fifth track. Once done, skip 5 frames and add another keyframe. Set the opacity on default, that is 100% on all files. Once done, let's render the video project.